Hello, and welcome back to part 4 of Let's Play Crash Team Racing. We have just obtained all 4 trophies from Glacier Park, as well as obtained the boss key from Komodo Joe, and also the purple CTR token from Rocky Road. So now we progress onto Citadel City. Now we have all 3 keys to allow access. Of course we take the left path because all of the other races are locked, so we complete them in a certain order. So the first race we can do is N.Gin Labs. Quite an easy track until you start trying to get the platinum relic because the placement of the crates can be a bit awkward.
Coming through.
I was not paying attention then. I won't really slow down that much. Of course I can block that attack pretty easily. More chance of hitting someone here. Yes. Now that was a skill shot. That's bound to get hit. Of course we have this boost tunnel here, which is really helpful for getting the speed up. Keep the drifter multiplier going. There should be no reason why you can't actually keep the speed. And of course I'm holding that much of a lead, the position counter started glitching out. Which happens quite frequently. As you can probably see on the map in the corner, my lead is pretty damn huge. Here we go. Once again, first place.
Congratulations, you win a trophy.
Of course, before I can do any of these races around here, I've got to jump down here and jump into Cortex Castle. Which is pretty much the only next race you can do.
Congratulations.
Then you have to complete Hot Air Skyway before you can race in Oxide Base. Catching up to do here. Right the way back in fifth place. If we take the shortcut here, which of course failed. Now I'm all the way back in sixth place. It just gets better. Of course, we've got invincibility, so it should give me a bit of advantage. Pretty intense jumps on this track, which only adds to the fun factor. Well, oh, almost. I'm not doing too well here. Of course, I actually managed to get a first place victory, which actually kind of surprised me because I weren't going too well at the start of this race. Hopefully I will do better in Hot Air Skyway, which is of course the next race we will be doing.
Congratulations, you win a trophy.
Yet another trophy. Here we go, Hot Air Skyway. I've already took the lead already. So off to a better start this time. For my opponents are not actually that far behind. Of course I got distracted. something I should really be doing. This is always tricky to get to this build because pad bricks are very helpful if you do use it. And of course I forgot once again that you cannot fire shields backwards. Or many other items in that matter. Like you can in other games, like Mario Kart and Sonic Transformed. Of course they can take advantage of the boost, just run along straight. Pretty much timed perfectly. Oh, don't know how that came about, but it was pretty shocking. I misaimed that completely. An absolute noob. Not to worry. Of course, N.Gin missed that. And N.Gin's getting far ahead, I don't know how that's going about. And of course, N.Gin took the shortcut, so I've got some catching up to do. Very nicely, we take a first place victory. For some reason, my DualShock 4 controller, which I'm playing this with, is flashing red. Apparently it's something to do with the latency glitch, but I don't feel any lag, it's just somehow the controller just glitches out for no apparent reason.
Congratulations, you win a trophy.
And now we can jump into Oxide Station and obtain the final trophy. No way I'm gonna get this boost to work back there.
Coming now.
And that were a near miss. Finally managed to find some bumper to collect, so I can get my weapons upgraded. Go. All 10 won through it. And now I've lost 3 because I got hit.
Yeah!
I've got like a whole lap just to hold on to first place. It's actually pretty easy to get the missiles to miss you. It's the terrain of the track and they're on the walls. Actually close to the track. I think my first place is pretty safe. I don't know why, but for some reason this kind of reminds me of some of the levels from Crash 2, Cortex Strikes Back, such as the jetpack levels, and Piston It Away and Spaced Out. I don't know why it should, but it kind of does in certain ways. There we go, we've got a final trophy.
Racing? Forget about it. If you's gonna face Oxide, you's gonna have to get past me first. I'm the speed champion here, and I'm gonna save the world. For a sizable fee, of course.
And now, we face the final boss challenge, Pinstripe. And we just crashed into that invisible wall again. Wow. Screwed up already.
Have some of this.
Gonna be hard to get the lead back now. Wow, I am not doing too well.
Watch your back. Oh.
Yes. The lead is mine.
Have some of this.
For how long? Not too sure, but. All I can do is try my dear hardest to keep it.
Have some of this!
We're already miles ahead of him. And also, Crash Team Racing's actually First time that Pinstripe actually makes a comeback since the actual first installment in the original series.
You're mine!
Which I think it's kind of nice to actually see him. Crash Team Racing. As a boss challenge. And a character that I believe he can actually race. Of course, without special abilities.
You're mine!
No, it's quite far behind. Don't know his weapons keep coming so close. Maybe just a glitch in the game software. Of course, get a boost. We have now obtained the final boss key.
So, you beat me fair and square. I doubt you'll be as lucky with Oxide. Here's a key for your troubles. Oh, brother.
Well, the little Terry-Vermin has finally collected all the trophies to become world champion.
Yep, that's right.
What took you so long? Now we prove who the fastest driver really is.
Which I'm pretty sure would be me. But we are not going to face Oxide yet, even though we can, because we've got... Because before we do that, I'm going to actually go back and complete the final Crystal Challenge, which I believe is Nitro Court. And this time we're going a different way for a change. So this way is much quicker. So now we take the right hand path and we enter Nitro Court to complete this one last final Crystal Challenge. And of course my strategy for this particular crystal challenge is to actually collect all crystals from the outside first and then work my way in step by step. And of course I'm hitting every Nitro Crate like an absolute dork. And again. I can definitely guarantee that I've got enough time to still complete the challenge, no matter how much I actually suck. That still did not give me enough room to get round. Not getting got again. Just had enough space here.
Whoa!
can definitely say that this is actually the easiest crystal challenge of the four. There we go. And finally, obtained the last CTR token. With my character ended up on a pretty awkward angle, as you can see, as a result of hitting that nitro crate. But, oh well. There we go. Before I continue, I'm going to quickly go back and save my progress, and I believe I should now have 40%. Because each four trophies, boss key, and a single CTR token is worth 10% each. So there we go, get my progress saved, like so. And in the next part, we are going to face the final boss, Nitrous Oxide, for the first time. There is also another time we have to go back and defeat him again. But of course that will come in the next part. So, once again guys, thanks a lot for watching part 4 of Let's Play Crash Team Racing. To see all the rest of the other parts, please remember to subscribe to this channel, and please also, if you enjoyed the video, drop a like, and feel free to leave a comment. Thanks for watching.